Hey guys, welcome back to another installment in our ChemSketch series. Today we're going to be learning how to draw lab equipment. Okay guys, I'm going to be working in the same sheet or same file that we've been using for the past few videos. So what I want to do is I'm going to go to the top as we looked at before and I'm going to add a new page. So now I'm working in page 3 of 3. And to do these templates, normally when I draw structures, I like to draw these structures zoomed in quite a bit so I can see them well and get them the way I want them. But when I'm working with lab setups, it's actually easier if you'll zoom out a bit because the lab setups you'll see are actually very large and they won't even hardly fit in your screen if you are zoomed in too much. So it's a lot easier if you'll just zoom out at least down to 100%. All right, to work in templates, you'll go to templates, template window. I'll move this over a little bit. And so you can see you have several things to choose from, you know, a lot of different things, a lot of structures. And on the left, you can see the different kind of kits that you have. And you got some carbohydrates and DNA, RNA, but the fourth one down is lab kit. And that's the one we're going to be focusing on today. So within this lab kit, there's actually several pages of lab equipment that you can choose from. And if you look at the top, you can see you can either do a drop down and you can look at all of your different pages of lab equipment. You can also kind of just scroll through it here and you can kind of look through and see the different things that you have available to you. Today, we're going to quickly draw a titration setup. So wherever you find something that you want to draw, just click on that and you can move over and position it where you want. You can see this is a very large drawing. That's why we zoomed out. When you're done, you can stamp as many of these as you want. I just want one. So you can either hit escape or you can click on your select arrow and that'll take it off so you don't keep stamping them down. I also want to go back and get an Erlenmeyer flask. I'm going to put this under my burette. Now one thing you'll notice, I'm having some trouble placing this. So I'm going to show you a trick to get this where you want. So I'm going to click it and you'll notice it's not exactly where I would want it to be. I want to go to options and you'll notice here the snap-on grid is checked. When the grid is checked, it's going to force your movements to kind of adhere to certain increments. So I'm going to click this off and it's going to give me a lot more freedom to move my items around just any way I want to. So now I can kind of take this and I can position it exactly where I want it. And that, for me at least, makes it a lot easier. As another example, I'm going to do a filtration setup. So I think that one, if I remember correctly, is in the basic kit. So here's a filtering flask. I need to go back and get my little stopper adapter and then get my funnel. And don't worry about placing these perfectly. You can always shift them around a little bit. And that looks pretty good. Now you will notice that it looks like my funnel is on top of my flask instead of inside of it. You can shift that around. So I'm going to start with the stopper by going up here to Objects, Send to Back, and then I'll get my Buckner funnel and do the same thing. And there, that looks better. Now, another thing that you can do, and you probably should do, if you're going to move these around, you can select with your rectangle select, you can select all these items and you can hit Object, Group, or Control G, either one. And that'll let you move these around. So if you click on this and you don't, it'll automatically select the entire group and you can shift them around without pulling your setup apart. If you don't do that, you can see, you know, I go to move this and I don't move all of it. And you hit Control Z to undo that. And then I'm going to select all of these, Control G, or of course, Object Group. Now, once objects are grouped, you can go back and you can ungroup them if you want to make a change individually. So it's not something that you're stuck with. You can always ungroup them. But now I can move these and they all move as a unit. Okay, you can pretty much probably take it from there, play around, see what different kinds of setups you can draw. And I hope this was helpful to you. I know this is a short video, but I think it's pretty much to the point. And we'll hope to see you back next time. We'll be talking about how to export these drawings and how to get them into your Word documents for your reports. Okay, guys, I hope this was helpful. Don't forget to like and subscribe to this video if it was something that you found useful. And we'll see you next time. We'll be talking about how to get these nice drawings that you're doing over into your lab report, into Word or a PowerPoint presentation. So see you next time.